this is the second part for presentation about financial deepening in Mexico. And this part is more technical, it's more theory oriented than the previous one. Let's go first with the outline of this talk. First, we'll talk about why we study financial deepening and why it's important for economic growth theory and for a lot of government policy intervention explanation. Then we talk about the model that we use, and I should stress out that this model was developed in 1990. It was published in 1990. It was developed probably 1988. So it's kind of 20-year-old model. And we talk about what exactly is the setup of this model and what those people achieved. This is GJ model, stands for Greenwood Jovanovich, two very famous economists. And then we talk about what Tausend and Ueda at Kenichi Ueda in 2006 achieved. So this is the first model that actually allowed quantitative estimation of financial deepening, and they applied to Thailand case, and they achieved pretty impressive results. And then finally, we go back to Mexico and we see what we obtained for Mexico, and this is fairly recent work, still in the progress. Okay, let's get started with why we study financial deepening. And financial deepening is it's kind of a recent topic in the genius economic growth theory model. If you go back into, let's say, 50s, 60s, you would see that most people would consider physical capital as the most important source of economic growth. And of course, it was a huge failure in many cases. You can remember Eastern Europe socialist bloc with rusty factories producing nothing of value. You can remember of Africa with hundreds of billions of economic aid, which also led to very inefficient allocation of capital. So this kind of opportunity for economic growth was strongly rejected overall by economic development in so many countries. And then, of course, more recent two more recent things are human capital, technology, and political institutions. They are still very much in favor, and but more recent work showed that there are more important mechanisms underlying all those three features that actually influence economic growth. For example, if you look up for technology, I mean, you remember China, medieval China, is very advanced technology for that age, and that never led to very impressive economic growth. Or human capital, for example. If you get more education, it doesn't mean that it helps economy if there are no jobs available that match your education. So what influences occupation choice and what matching mechanism exists in the economy is much more important than simply adding more years in education or healthcare and providing better healthcare and so on. And of course, the most recent thing is political institution. Of course, it's very popular right now to use this as a driver for economic growth. But again, it's very difficult to prove causation in this case because, well, you say this country has a very good political institution, well, then they have very good economy, but what causing what is not very clear again. And the financial intermediaries kind of stay on its own. There are very few research articles that actually address this case. If, for example, if you look at the Encyclopedia of Economic Growth by Acemoglu, it's a 1,000-page thick book. There's a lot of formulas with a lot of theories explained, but financial intermediation, it's practically nothing in there. But on the other hand, the more recent research is, well, they say it causal link convincingly established. I put a question mark here. It might be too strong a statement, but at the same time, there's overwhelming evidence that the stronger banks, stronger financial systems helps economic growth. I mean, I should stress this even now when we are in the middle of a financial crisis, that when everyone is talking about how bad the financial system is, how much damage the banks did, we should still remember that how much growth it provided before that crisis. And what's important here, what's important in this segment is that this stronger financial institution actually help less wealthy people more than they help wealthy people. There is a lot of evidence that the benefit for the stronger financial system is actually transfer to the poor people as well. And they actually gain much more from this tight financial system grows. They actually grow faster than richer people. In many cases, this is absolutely true. And at the same time, it's not very well researched topic in economic growth theories.